Good morning, friends. We are bigdatahandson.com. So today is day 25. We are going to see mean shift and hierarchical algorithms. These are two algorithms, clustering algorithms. So previously we have seen the k-means clustering and dbscan. Okay, so day 25. The videos you can find it in our YouTube channel bigdatahandson.com. So you can see here is previously taken video, and all other videos previously taken are be uploaded in our YouTube channel. You can subscribe to our channel, you will get all the notifications. And our website is bigdatahandson.com, so you can visit our website. This is our contact number. If you have any doubts, you can send messages in this number, or you can send email through support@bigdatahandson.com. Okay, so now let's jump into our today's topic, that is hierarchical clustering and mean shift. Okay. So today we'll start with hierarchical clustering. So hierarchical clustering is one of the popular and easy to understand clustering technique. This clustering technique is divided into two types. So in hierarchical clustering also we have two types. So agglomerative and divisive. Agglomerative or and divisive, it's opposite of each other, you can say. So hierarchical clustering, how it works is, it start with the all the data points are considered a single clusters. So initially, and it will create a clusters until you have one cluster. So all the data points are into a one clusters. So initially all the data points are considered a different clusters, and then it will combine each other, and then until you will get a hierarchy cluster. So it's cover all the data points. So actually how it works is, for example, we have two algorithms, right, in agglomerative and divisive. So if I will just explain your agglomerative, and you will get divisive as well. So because it's the opposite of agglomerative, that's why. So agglomerative hierarchical clustering technique, we'll see. In this technique, initially each data point, I said before, so are considered an individual clusters. Okay, so every data point is now a individual clusters initially, and then at each iteration the similar clusters merge with the other clusters until one cluster or k clusters are formed. Okay, so we will join these two clusters. For example, if you have a 10 data points, initially the 10 data points are 10 clusters. So and then each iteration, what will happen, the clusters are join each other, who are in the closest to one. So we'll combine the closest two clusters, and then again we'll again we'll join the two clusters based on the distance. Okay, so and then we'll form until we do this until one cluster or k clusters are formed. If you are giving k clusters, for example, I want three clusters. So initially from individual clusters, it will form until three clusters. Like that it will do. Okay. So the basic algorithm of agglomerative is straightforward. So these are the steps are involved in agglomerative. So the first steps, compute the proximity matrix. So proximity matrix is we use for calculating the distance. And let each data point be a cluster. So initially in the agglomerative, it takes all the data points are considered an individual cluster. And now repeat this step, the step 3, merge the two closest clusters and update the proximity matrix, okay, until one is only a single cluster remains. So this was the four steps we have, and then this how the hierarchical cluster is look like. So initially we have A, B, C, D, E, F. So we have six clusters now, individual clusters. Now what happens is in the next iteration, the closest to two clusters are combined. So you can see B and C are closest to one, and D and E are closest to one. So these are combining. And after that, what happens is we are combining one more time, closest two clusters. So like D, E and the F cluster. And then again, we are combining the BC cluster and DEF cluster, and then BCDF. And then we'll combining A cluster to this cluster, we'll get a single cluster, right? ABCDEF. So this was the hierarchical clustering is working, or you can say agglomerating, okay? So to visualize the hierarchical algorithm, hierarchical clustering algorithm, we have a special type of visualization technique that is called dendrograms. So this is how the dendrogram is look like. So you can see we have individual clusters here, A, B, C, D, E, F. So what happens is it's combining the B, C clusters. So you can see the box here, right? And D, E cluster. Like that, it combines and then it's combining D, E and the F cluster. And then DEF to BC cluster, and then BCDEF to A cluster. That's why. So you can see here also. So this is just an animation for the hierarchical clustering. So you can see the points are merging, right? The clusters are merging. So individual clusters to one cluster, and then again merging to the closest ones. So after this, you have a dendrogram, right? So it will, I said before, until this process will happen, until you have a single cluster or K clusters. For example, if I am given three clusters, it will stop here, right? So we have a three clusters. So it will join, merge the clusters until you get three clusters. So or you want here, so it will stop two clusters, right? So we have two clusters. Here we have three clusters. If I draw a line here, it will be four clusters, or here five clusters. It's like that is happening, okay? So we have a two type of algorithms, right, in hierarchical. So we have agglomerative and divisive. So agglomerative is, initially agglomerative takes each data point individual clusters to single cluster. But in divisive, so it takes all the data points in a single cluster and dividing each other, and then you will get an individual cluster. It's an opposite of each other, right? Opposite of agglomerative divisive. Okay, so let's see the implementation. So now I will start my spider. So it takes some time to start. Okay, so now we'll create a new file. we'll save this file as agglomerative. We'll remove the content, and now I'm going to import a module. The module is matplotlib to visualize the plot. matplotlib.pyplot. Okay. And now we need the data set. We'll import some dummy data we'll create. So to create the dummy data for clustering, so we can use a function called makeblobs in the sklearn library. We have a module data sets. Here we have a function makeblobs. Okay, it will return two values x and y, and you need to call the function make blobs, and you have to give the number of samples. Number of samples equal to, let's say, 1500, and now we'll give some random state because every time it will change. So we set a random state to 30, and now we will get a data set. If you run the variable explorer, you can see you will have three clusters in that, three classes. As you can say, we have two features and three classes, 0, 1, 2. Okay, so it's look like a cluster only, that's why I said. And now to visualize it, you can simply create a scatter plot using plt.scatter. And we have two features right in X. So we'll take one feature as x-axis and one variable as y-axis. So you can simply say x:0, this first feature, and one is second feature. Okay, and then we have a color for that. So color is the labels. Okay, so labels is changes, then color will change for the data point. And now we need to show the plot. Okay, let's run these two lines. So this was the data points, this is the blobs, you can say. So we're going to create a cluster like this. So we have these data points, so we are given the labels, but we are not going to use the labels, the y variable. So without using the y variable, we are going to create the clustering algorithms. So I said before, we have to visualize the hierarchical clustering, we have a special type of plot, that is dendrogram. So how we can create a dendrogram is simply you need to import two functions for that. So from the sci-fi library, sci-fi.cluster.hierarchy. yeah, in this module we have two functions, that is dendrogram and linkage. So I want to explain you the linkage, what it is. I will tell you right. Okay, so initially we have said we have an axis x and y, let's say, and we have some data points in that. let's draw some data points here, 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 and here, and here. Okay, so now what agglomerative does is it will take the data points individual clusters. So now this is a cluster, this is a cluster, this is a cluster. So we have individual clusters, right? So and then what happens is these are individual clusters. So and then what will happen, we need to merge the two closest clusters, right? So these two are the closest clusters. How we find the closest clusters? Using some distance functions, right? So let's say we have these closest clusters. I'm going to combine the two clusters. So now we have a single cluster. So combining these two clusters, and after creating these two clusters, again we need to find the closest cluster. We need to combine it. So let's say these two are the closest one. So this cluster and this cluster. So in this cluster, let's say in the big cluster, we have two points, right? So if you have two points, how we will find this? Let's say you have two clusters to find. You have to find the distance, right? How will you find? We'll find, let's say, the center. Let's say. So initially you have individual data points, so you can find the distance with the data points itself. But now we have two clusters inside one cluster, so you. You have some methods to calculate the distance to the cluster. That's denoted. You can create the linkage using the linkage function. So in the linkage function, we have various methods like average. We have complete, single, what. These are the methods for calculating the distance between the clusters. So I will tell you first this. Let's say average cluster. So in average cluster, what will happen is, so we'll take the mean of the cluster. So we have two points, right? So we take the mean. Let's say the mean is here. So it's here, let's say. Okay, so it's here the mean is. Now and then we take the mean as the point, and then we'll calculate the distance between the cluster and the two clusters based on the mean of the value. So we have only one value here, so we can take the data point as the point. And now we have two clusters in it, so we'll calculate the mean. That's the average method. So we'll calculate the mean and take the point as the point for the cluster. Okay, and then we'll calculate the distance like this. Okay, and then again we'll combine the clusters. So we have combined these two clusters. Now again we need to combine with the closest one. Now we have another method. So we have seen the average that will calculate the mean of the points, okay, and take the mean value as the point for the cluster, okay. And now we have another method, that is a single method. Single, what happens is in single we take the minimum value of the data points. So let's say this point is 1 and 2 and 3. So we take the minimum point. This is the minimum point, right? Okay. So single method is takes the minimum point. Okay. And then we'll calculate the distance between the minimum point and the other cluster data point. Okay. So we'll calculate the distances, or you can say. So we'll combine the closest one. This is the closest one. So we'll combine it. Combine the this cluster, and I will draw from here. Oh, let's combine like this. No. Okay, so we are combining like this. Okay, so and then we have another method. So we have seen average and single. So let's see complete. So complete method, what it does is, so in complete method we take the maximum value. So let's take this a maximum value. So using that maximum value we'll calculate the distance between the clusters. Okay, so and then we'll combine the all other clusters. So and then we have another method, that is WAD method, I think. So WAD method uses their own equation to calculate the distance between two clusters. So all the different clusters are you can see in the website of SKLearn. So they have demonstrated a difference between other linkages. So you can see we have average, complete, ward and single, right? So how it works for different types of data sets, their linkages, how it works. Okay, so average method takes the mean value of the cluster, and complete takes the maximum, ward uses the equation, and single is the minimum value. Okay, I hope you got it. Now that's what the linkage function is used for, to calculate the distance between two clusters. Okay, so now we need to create a link, right? We need to create a linkage for the data set. It's linkage, and here it takes some parameters. You can see y is the data point you can give. So let's give the x as well. And now method, default method is single, so it will take the minimum value. Metric, Euclidean, so we have in we have Euclidean distance, like Manhattan distance we have. So you can select what's the distance function you want to use. Okay, so I'm going to give the data x, and method I'm going to give average method. Okay, that's it. So we'll create a link. After creating a link, you need to create a dendrogram. So that can be done by this function, dendrogram. You need to call the function. You have imported the dendrogram function, and you want to give the linkage. Okay, by giving the linkage, it will create the dendrogram, and you have to give the labels. Labels is nothing but initially we have a individual clusters, right? So that's what the label actually. Let's take the labels equal to range of 1,11, 1,16 I will take. So we'll have 1 to 15 values. So instead of 1500 samples, I will just for demonstration I will create 15 samples. And for simple 15 samples, we have 15 labels, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. Okay, and then we'll call the function, we'll give the linkage, orientation, top, and we'll give the labels we have created, and distance or descending, surely if counts true. Okay, after this it will create a plot. We need to show that, plt.show. Now that's it. So after running that, you will see a dendrogram plot. It is taking some time to create. Oh, labels is the error here. Yeah, here you can see. Now we have the dendrogram plot, right? So we have 1 to 15 labels, 1 to 15 clusters, you can say. And it's just combining the closest ones. Okay, so this is how it's working. Now you will create a dendrogram. Okay, now let's come to the model creation. So we'll command these lines. Okay, so now we are going to create a model using agglomerative. So you have a class for the agglomerative cluster. We have a class inside the SKLearn library. We have a cluster module. So I said we have used before. So in this cluster module, you will find all the clustering algorithms like dbScan, agglomerative, mean shift, affinity propagation, spectral. These are all other clustering methods. That's it. So we import agglomerative clustering. Okay, and then we'll create an object for the agglomerative cluster, and we'll call the class. And we have some parameters. If you want to see that, you can press Control I to inspect. So what we have, recursively measures the pair of clusters that minimally increases a given linkage distance. Okay, that's agglomerative. And parameters are number of clusters, int or none, default is 2. Number of clusters to find, it must be none if distance threshold is not none. Okay, and then we have affinity, so distance function. And we have memory, we don't want connectivity, we want linkage. So we want to give the linkage, right? Word, complete, average or single. So default is word. So here we have a description about word, I think. Word minimizes the variance of the clusters being merged. Okay. Average uses the average of distances of each observation of two sets. Okay, complete method or maximum linkage. So I have said that right. So complete means maximum linkage. Uses the maximum distance between all the observations of the two sets. And single uses the minimum of the distances between all observations of the two sets. Right. The minimum, maximum, average, word. Okay, and that's it. Now we'll give the parameter. Number of clusters we want. So initially this make blobs will create 3 clusters. So now we'll give the 3 clusters here and let's see how it's just dividing the clusters. Okay, and now we want to give the affinity is Euclidean, right? Yeah, Euclidean. And we will give the linkage as average. We'll use the average linkage. Okay, now we created the cluster. Let's run this. Okay, sorry, that's it, that linkage, I think, not link. So we have created the object. Now we want to fit this cluster into the data set and we'll predict. Both we'll do in one shot. We can do using the fit predict function. Fit underscore predict. So it will fit and predict, both will done by the fit predict function, and you will give the data set. Okay, so and then we want the labels, right? Labels means the cluster names, so that can be get by this function cluster dot labels underscore. Okay, this will give you the labels. So now we'll run these 2 lines. Now we have fitted the data set into the cluster, and now we created the labels. So we have given 3 clusters, right? So it will have where is that labels here? Okay, I think I haven't run after changing 1500. Okay, we'll run the whole code. Okay, so we have 0, 1 and 2. So we have 3 clusters. The names are 0, 1 and 2. Okay, so this plot is created before the clustering. Now we'll create After the clustering, we'll create the plot. Sorry, scatter. Okay, let's copy and paste here. And we'll change the color. Instead of Y, we'll put labels here. Okay, now we'll run these two lines. Okay, you can see after the clustering. So it's similar to the previous one. So you can see, right? It's managed to cluster everything. You can see some override points here. So this blue color in the violet color are intersected, right? So in the hierarchical model, it's just created the violet color cluster. It is a perfect cluster here. So you can see a perfect cluster, right? The prediction also the perfect one. Okay, this is how the agglomerative hierarchical clustering is working. I just searched in internet for divisive also. I couldn't find any algorithms like in the cluster also. We don't have that, I think. Yeah, we doesn't have the divisive for divisive algorithm. We have just agglomerative. Okay, so now we'll move on to the other clustering algorithm. The next we'll see min shift, right? Okay, it's not responding. Sometimes it happens for me. So previous session, my system hanged and shut down automatically. So that's why I left the meeting. So 89% of memory is using for me. We'll just close some applications. This I don't want. This will close. I'll close this one also. So now we have three applications running. Okay. I think actually we have other clustering algorithms also. In this series, I have put out only four clusters, but we have many cluster algorithms. You can see that. We'll see that. So these are the clustering algorithms. I think they have done a visualization comparison. So these are the comparison is on the different types of dummy datas. So the circle, the moon, the blobs, so like that. You can see here we have other algorithms like mini batch k-means, affinity propagation. This is the main shift we will see. Spectral clustering, we have Ward method, agglomerative clustering, DB scan, optics, Birch, and Gaussian mixture. So this is how all the clustering algorithms we have. In this series, I have put only 4 clustering algorithms. It's okay, no problem. So we'll see the next clustering algorithm, that is mean shift. So mean shift, as a name, you can what do you understand is mean shift. So it will shift where the mean is. Okay, the same concept is applied in the mean shift algorithm. So it will shift the window. So we'll take the window as the radius of the sliding window, and we'll calculate the mean of the points inside the window, and then it will shift the window where the mean is. So this will happen, the step is repeated until we get the convergence. So convergence, you can say a density area, I can say. So it will repeat this operation until you will get the convergence. Okay, so mean shift essentially starts off with a kernel, which is basically a circular sliding window. The bandwidth, so we have the bandwidth function for to calculate the bandwidth, and the radius of this sliding window will be pre-decided by the user. We will decide the radius of the window using the bandwidth we'll use na. This will create the windows. And now the step one, so we have 4 steps. We have step one is pick any random point and place the window on that data point. We'll pick the random point and we'll place the window on the data point, and we'll calculate the mean of all points lying inside this window, and we shift the window such that it is lying on the location of the mean, and we'll repeat the steps until we get the convergence. Very simple algorithm, but it's actually a complex one. So you will see what happens here. See what happening here. Sorry. So you can see various type of bandwidths we have. Bandwidth 0.5, 1.5, 2, like that. Okay. So these are the convergence actually. So this is a convergent, this is a convergent, this is a convergent. Okay, now we'll see the implementation. Okay, we'll create a new file and save it. Mean shift. So the same one, we'll import the matplotlib and create the blobs, and we can visualize the plot. The same thing happens here. Okay, so this will give you the same plot, right? Just giving the same plot. Now what we are going to do is we are going to create the model. So if you want to create the mean shift model, first you want to create the bandwidth. Okay, so to create that, we have a function inside the sklearn library. So we have a cluster module, right? So inside this we have one class, that is mean shift class, and we have bandwidth, estimate bandwidth function. This function is used to create the bandwidth. Okay, so first we'll create the bandwidth. We'll call the function estimate bandwidth, and it takes some parameters. We'll see that what are the parameters are. Press Control I, or you can also see that information in the sklearn website. So this is the sklearn.cluster.estimate bandwidth function. So we have parameters like x, the input points, and quantile should between 0 to 1. 0.5 means that median of all pairwise distance is used. Number of samples, the number of samples to use, if not given, all samples are used. Okay, we'll set the random state and number of jobs. So this was the function. Is it returns the bandwidth of the bandwidth parameter. Okay, so now we'll give the x data and we'll give the quantile. So we'll give quantile as the default one is 0.3, I think. So we'll give the default one as okay. Number of samples we don't want to give, so we'll take all the samples, 1500 we'll take to consider. Okay, now and then what we need to do is we need to create the object for mean shift. So we'll say cluster equal to mean shift. We need to call the class, and then in the first parameter you need to give the bandwidth first. So you can see the first is the bandwidth. If not given, the bandwidth is estimated using sklearn cluster. If you don't give the bandwidth also, it actually creates the bandwidth using the same function we have used, the estimate bandwidth. Okay, and now we'll give the bandwidth we have calculated. Okay, and then what other parameters we have? Seats, we have maximum iteration also. So why we have maximum iteration is, so what happened in the mean shift is, it's actually it can start with any data points, right? So initially it start with the random data points, so it's do until you get the convergence. So every data points will again and again will the mean shift will iter with the different data points, the random data points. So we can set the max iteration also. So the default one is 300, so it will iter on 300 times until it will give the convergence. Okay, now so in this algorithm also we don't want to specify the number of clusters, I think. So we don't have any parameters like number of clusters, so it's automatically creates the number of clusters based on the convergence, right? Convergence is the clusters for us. K means takes the clusters, number of clusters is asks. And dbscan doesn't have the number of clusters, so it automatically creates the clusters. In Occlerometry we have the number of clusters, but in the mean shift we don't have. But mean shift algorithm has some disadvantages. The disadvantages is the time consumption. So it takes a long time to calculate the convergence, because it iters, right? It automatically iters on the data points, randomly pick the data point and calculating the distances. So it will take long to calculate the convergence. That's why when compared to other algorithm, mean shift is a slow one. So you want to predict the x data sets. Now we have the labels, we want to plot it. So the same two lines we'll copy and paste it here. Okay, now we'll run this program. So you can see the running time will take long. You can see, so we have, because we have 1500 data sets, so it will take a long time. you can see the it takes long, right? Now it's completed. This is the final result. So this is the blobs we have created. This is the convergence created by the main shift algorithm. So it's actually work well, I think. Yeah, let's create some different blobs, or you can also create some different shapes of data sets. We'll create let's say moons we'll create. So in thing we have the function for creating the moons. Yeah, make moons, and we need to give the number of samples. Okay, we'll take 1000, comment this line. So this is the moon, and now it is predicting. Takes some time. This is the main disadvantages of main shift. It takes long time. We'll try the moon for the DB scan. It doesn't created, right? The moons. We'll try that on DB scan. It's taking a long time. So it's taken a long time, but it's created a single cluster. It doesn't work. Okay, now we'll see DB scan with the moons dataset. Yeah, it's working right. Perfectly, it's created the cluster. So maybe the standard scaler is a problem. We'll do that here. Standardize the scale and then create the model. Let's try. In the moons dataset, DB scan also working very well. Main shift takes long time, that's a problem. Okay. Yeah, it's created. So here it created two clusters on the center, dividing the moons. But DB scan works very well, right? It's predicted the moon. Because the DB scan is working with the density based function actually. So what happens is where the density is, it will go through the density. So here we have the density, so it will go through the density right here. And here we don't have any data points, so it will start from here. And we have the density, it follows the density and create the clusters. Okay, this was the four clusters we have seen. K-means, DBSCAN, agglomerate, one mean shift. Any doubts in that? You can ask now. So we'll end up this session here from here. Any doubts you can ask? Any doubts? One person said didn't get the output from final graphs from make moons. Why you are not giving? You commented the line before and call the function make moons. So first you want to import it from the data sets and then you want to call the function. What can we explain it? No, it's like we are just comparing how the algorithms are working on a different shapes of data. So we have a different shapes like moons and we have like blobs. We have like this. Have a circular. This actually a circular is like you can say this non. Linear I think non-linear data, so it look like that only. So how the algorithms are working on a different shapes of data, that's what it is. So you can see here you will get an idea like this. So we have a density right here, right? We have a density plot. So if you have a density plot, a density based data, so some algorithms are like, see here, the k-means. So k-means also dividing the density on three parts. But some algorithms just created a single cluster because it's based on the density. So mean shift and DB scan, optics and agglomerative clustering. So other algorithms have created based on the cluster. So it divide the divide based on the clusters. Number of clusters we have given. Okay, now any other algorithms? So any other doubts? Circles, moons, blobs, random data. Okay. Oh. K neighbors graph. Okay, any other doubts you have? No doubts. So we are bigdatahandson.com. So our website is bigdatahandson.com. So today we have completed day 25. It is hierarchical and mean shift clustering algorithm. So this is our contact number 9789844. You can message us in this number if you have any doubts, and you can send this in this email address support@bigdatahandson.com. And all the recorded sessions will be uploaded in our YouTube channel. So all the previous these are the previous sessions I have taken. So if you subscribe the our channel, you will get all the notifications. So we'll see tomorrow. Bye.